Hey, playa, do you ever find yourself getting jealous because your crush is talking to other people or hanging out with them and not really investing time into getting closer to you? Don't worry. In this video, I'm going to talk you through how to deal with those feelings of anger and jealousy and annoyance and how to start getting closer to your crush so you don't have to feel them anymore.
This is the Just Beats. You're watching the Just Beats.
My name is Josh, and every single week I make videos sharing tips, ideas, and stories teaching you how to be your best self. And I think the problem you might be running into is that you are idealizing your crush. You feel like they're not interested in anyone else. They don't want to pursue anyone else or date them. So that gives you the open field to pursue them. And that's a major mistake I think a lot of people run into. They fantasize that no one else likes their crush. They have no major prospects. So it can be kind of hard to hear that someone else likes them, or even worse, your crush likes someone else that's not you. This is where those feelings start to really coalesce and truly get under your skin. Huh, my crush sure does like to text that person a lot. Oh, so he's gonna walk her home after school. No problem. Why does she keep telling me she's busy, but she keeps posting pictures on social media with other guys? Here's the truth. Other people also like your crush. I know you don't want to hear that, you don't even want to think about that, but if you start to feel like there is competition surrounding them, if you feel like other people are getting closer to your crush when that should be you, you need to step up. The thing about stepping up, though, is recognizing what the real challenge is. It's not you versus all these other people, it's you versus yourself. How you feel and think about the situation, what you're willing to do, how much you're willing to put yourself out there, how honest and vulnerable and confident you're gonna be in the exchange with your crush. It's easy to feel like you're at a disadvantage here because other people just seem to smoothly be integrating with your crush a lot better. But have you tried actually asking them out? Have you tried walking up to them and talking to them when you see them in the hallways? Have you tried DMing them or asking them to video chat or just straight up telling them that you want to spend time with them one-on-one? Making a move is definitely a better strategy than waiting for the right moment or the right opportunity to actually start talking to them. You need to do it as soon as you can, but what do you do in the meantime when you do see them interacting with other people, hanging out with them, or even potentially flirting with them? How do you handle that? Now, this might sound a bit backwards because you like this person and you want to go out with them, but I think in the meantime, you should still be pursuing other people. This is going to prevent you from falling into what's called oneitis, where you like one person and you're only willing to pursue them, you only have eyes for them, you're only thinking about them, and you're neglecting everyone else that you could potentially date and develop a stronger connection with. Sometimes you like someone so much that you become blinded to the idea of pursuing anyone else. And when that happens, your happiness and your sadness become determined by whatever your crush decides to do. Hey, they're not talking to anyone right now. Yeah. And there they go, giving that person a hug and a kiss on the cheek. Pursuing multiple people here is going to be beneficial for a multitude of reasons. The first one being that you're going to be working on your dating skills. You're going to be getting better at flirting and texting and talking to someone, so that's a plus. The second piece is that you're going to start to feel more confident in your ability to approach someone. The more you do it, the more you actually go for it, the easier it's going to be to finally do it with your crush. And third, you're gonna start to compare. A lot of times we like our crush because we're just infatuated with them. But as you meet more people, you start to pick up on the skills you wanna find in a partner. And then it becomes easier to see if your crush aligns with that. But at the end of the day, we're human. We might still feel jealous or sad or angry seeing our crush with someone else. So how do you manage? Well, I think the best thing that you can do is to find a healthy way to express your feelings. That might mean taking up a skill like meditation and breathing exercises so that when you are feeling agitated and annoyed, you can breathe to help center yourself and calm yourself down. Or it might mean exercising, getting super swole, putting on muscle, feeling good about the way that you look so that you can be more presentable to anyone else that you approach. Or it might just be finding a friend that you can open up to, someone that you can share your feelings with and talk about. Having a person there to support you is gonna be crucial in these dark times when you're jealous and angry and upset. So find someone that you can talk to and share things with. Jealousy is definitely something that takes time to work through. So check out the video over here on the side where I go deeper into how to manage your jealous feelings. This is something that you can definitely work on and take control of. Also, I want to give a huge shout out to all my patrons and YouTube channel members. These are the people that help support the channel every single month. So if you want to learn how you could talk to me one-on-one, check out the link to Patreon down below. On that note, guys, I'll catch you next time. As always, love and peace.